Time. The reason why God is a just God. If he gave it to me, he'll give it to you. If he gave me the Holy Ghost, he'll give you the Holy Ghost. But you got to get hungry for it and stop playing with God. Got to get hungry for it. He that hunger and thirst after righteousness shall be filled. So today we're going to be dealing with getting hungry for the things of God, for the Holy Ghost of God. Let's go to the Word of God. Father, do I thank God for my wife, the late Lady Joan. Thank God for everybody that came out today, that took their precious time and came out. We appreciate having y'all today. Thank God. I forgot to mention it before. I want to thank God for that good food at the fellowship. I keep forgetting. That food was so good to me. I forgot to tell y'all about it. Y'all really stepped up to the plate with that food. I was like, wow, this is good. But anyway, we're getting ready to go to the Word of God. Let's go to the book of Psalms, chapter 42. And verse number 2 and 3. Psalms chapter 42 and verses number 2 and 3. He that hungers and thirsts after righteousness shall be filled. Thank God for the ladies and the children, the teenagers that kept them. And went out there yesterday, Minister Craig idea, that was God gave her. And well, he went out on outreach. And I just thank God for it. We were scrambling the horse after that, screaming at them cars and hollering at them cars. My goodness. We just thank God. I enjoyed every moment. It was good. We just thank God. Let's go to Psalm chapter number, praise the Lord, I think it's Psalm chapter number 42 and verse number 2 and 3. Are we there yet? Psalm 42, verses number 2 and 3. See what the Word of God say. Well, I'm going to start with verse 1. As the heart panted after the water brook, so panted my soul after thee, O God. My soul thirsted for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? My tears have been my meat day and night. While they continually say unto me, where is thy God? Amen. I want to mention this. This man sought the Lord with tears. Sought the Lord with tears. Well, in my opinion, men don't like crying before God. Let me tell you something. In my opinion, that's one of the most masculine things that you can do, is humble yourself in the presence of a living God. I want to hear how macho you are. There's so many macho men, they're going to go to hell because they can't humble themselves in the presence of a living God. They can't come to God and cry, say, Lord, I need the Holy Ghost. They can't come to God and cry, say, Lord, I want to be saved. But when they come and I'm like a child and cry before God, God is able to fill them with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. But you got to humble yourself. Amen. Hallelujah. So you got to get hungry for it. Got to get hungry for it. I remember, you got to get hungry for it. Let's go to the Word of God a little further. Let's go to the Word of God. The Word of God says in the book of 2 Kings, chapter number 20, verse number 1 through 5. 2 Kings, chapter number 20, verse number 1 through 5. Ever get enough? Say amen. Somebody don't want to cry. But let me tell you something. You don't want to humble yourself and cry. For some of y'all, it's going to be hard to get the Holy Ghost. You got to want the Holy Ghost more than you want anything out of your life. More than diamonds and pearl. More than husband. More than wife. The Bible says in one place, he that loveth father and mother more than me, children, son and daughter more than me, is not worthy of me. Husband and wife is not worthy of me. So sometimes you got to understand what God got to give you today. You got to comprehend that in your mind, what God is offering you today. You got to get holy for it. You got to seek it. You got to want it. You got to crave it. You got to almost lust after the Lord. I want this more than anything else on the face of this earth. I want this more than the breath that I breathe. And if you get holy for it, the Lord can fill you with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. 2 Kings chapter number 20 and verse 1. In those days was Hezekiah sick unto death, and the prophet Isaiah, the son of Amos, came to him and said unto him, thus saith the Lord, set thy house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Did he turn his face to the wall and prayed unto God, saying, I beseech thee, O Lord, remember now how I have walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and have done that which was good in thy sight. And Hezekiah done what? Now he wept sore. The king of Israel, people had to bow to the king. People had to obey the king. The king was mad enough to cry before God. The king was mad enough to humble himself and cry and weep before God. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. See what God unto the house of the Lord, and I will add unto thy days 50